Thank you. I think I'm closer to the second family than to show you. She dared to say in the 90s the prophecy that the financial world was going to crash because the financial world of Wall Street was operating out of the rule of law. It was doing all these secret, fraudulent operations in secret, and neither Congress nor government and no one would control them. I hope you are aware that that situation
and you know, how they bring us all together. Usually the conversation for a mother is she nurtures and she brings together the family. That's what I think about.
Okay, I will give you a fast answer, I think. This may not be true because I'm not a historian, but I was a teenager in your age when feminism started to sound. And this wonderful thing that I think we should all see that was premiered at MoMA maybe 10 weeks ago, and it's called The Heretics. And it's a history of fantastic magazine that existed in New York called The Heretics Collective. And when I came to New York in 1980, I was invited to join this, and therefore I am in this movie. And the wonderful thing that you see in this movie is how feminist was. And here I tell the story of being a young girl and only hearing that this thing called feminism is happening in the US and it's happening in Europe. In Chile, nobody has heard about it, nobody could care less about it. But there's one big girl, me, who hears about it, and there's probably serious other big girls that me hear about it all over the world, and this wave begins in us. This desire to be completely ourselves, to be completely free, and to know that if other women are doing it, then it is possible for all of us to do it. And I think what happened is that in the beginning, women, especially women artists, are acknowledged what was called the mother goddess. And you probably know that human culture is being pushed back by a few million years. For example, there was recently a skull found that is 4 million years old. So we as people are not a million years old, but probably 4 million years old. And for most of that time, women, that is to say the female animal and the male animal, engaged in a powerful collaboration, in an exchange. And the rule of one to the next, the one over the next, is not assured, and it's not necessarily the case even among animals. For example, in hyenas, it is she who rules and organizes the society, and it is so with many animals. So the historic notion that women sort of manage the world is evident in art for a few thousand years, and if you study that, you will find most beautiful art, and for thousands of years, apparently there was no war. There was this culture that was involved in the love of life and the love of nature. So the early feminists were focused on that. And then a new wave of feminists say, we are nature, we are people. And so this disregard for nature emerged within the feminist movement. And I'm going to be associated with our biology. We do not necessarily, I mean, we necessarily fashion. I mean, really not related to the body. I think there's a coming around now, and I hope I'm right that if you ask that question, you are probably wanting a different answer.
You had said when you were born that your parents looked at you, that you were a girl, and they didn't want you. What do you think you can, or women in the world can do to change that attitude?
The first thing is that when a mother has been born, if this mother can feel joy and love and completely accept the miracle of the birth and not judging and judge herself as having failed, that is the question that a mother needs to make in the first place. If mothers could do that, then the baby would know that she is a person and not less than a person. It's for young mothers that
big change. Thank you. Of this collective consciousness that we are all becoming aware of. And then you also spoke of a different type of knowledge, one that isn't really found in the classroom. That's something I really relate to. Can you speak on how you gain that type of knowledge outside of the classroom and outside of this type of university setting?
Okay, thank you. Yes, the reason why I showed you the Kama Chakra piece is because if you think of this place where I was conceived, actually, my father says that the night of love I was conceived. conceived in front of the Pacific Ocean in the very same place where the film was shot. So if you think that this cloud animal is there, present, and most people ignore that because it's not in books. You see, people don't consider this any value. So how do you become empty enough to relate to that cloud animal? To relate to the meaning of the name. That is the art. The art is to become open, alert, sensitive, to become completely present to what you don't know. When you don't know something, you're aware that you don't know, a new knowing can unfold. It is to the acknowledgement that within knowledge there is a not knowing that is fertile, that is active. So that's how I learn from the space of light. I go to the space of complete emptiness where I know nothing and I just breathe. And then,
thank you.